guys, so I lost my connection, so on the server. I knew something was up. This Nitrado server, I don't know. I honestly don't think I could recommend it, because it's just not that good. So we're in the midst of selling our grain, barley. And I looked back on my Excel spreadsheet, it was like 930,000 liters of barley, and it was valued at like 176 at base price, 176,000. So I think we've already got there, or pretty dang close, so we should do about 70% more than that. I think the big thing about the 36 footers is you have a lot more braking power, so it's easier to handle that heavy load. Obviously, you have the axles for your weight requirement, but it's definitely easier to handle because you have more wheels, more brakes. This 23 is going to end up being a really nice fuel, I think. Oh my god, there's our following mod, guys. What is this guy doing? I tell you, follow me mod. It works great unless you're going over 15 miles an hour, in which case, it's terrible. It would be great if it not only followed the path, but actually like mimic your speed that you're going to at that data point. Like it records your speed at that data point. So it doesn't come in pedal to the metal on a turn. attempted to make this map MR. Just so the economy if I have a great demand, the price doesn't go down. If a great demand is 10 hours, the price is like that for 10 hours. It doesn't go down after the first hour. That's what really bothers me. It's like, what's the point of having a great demand for a crop if you unload it and then the next hour the price plummets, even while the great demand is still going up? That bothers me like none other. Feels good to go to some other place than Conagra. I swear to God, Conagra was always getting a great demand. Another thing I noticed is the missions don't work on multiplayer server. It is unfortunate. Because I made a lot of personal missions to these sell points for specific grains, like specific great demands, so not even halfway through our grain yet. Be able to haul so much more grain if we were both, someone else was driving that truck in the back. Definitely gonna need extra help with demand for corn comes. I used to have Courseplay run like 4 or 5 trucks for corn grain demands. Thank you. spot this rear dolly, so that shouldn't be getting dirty at all. Gotta love these pace setters. See, this guy comes hauling ass and doesn't emulate or replicate my speed going into the turn. So I'd like to see that fix in Follow Me Mod, and then Follow Me Mod would be pretty solid. That's the only huge downside to Follow Me Mod is that records your path, but it doesn't record the speed at that data point, which it really should. And it should mimic what you do with your implement too. If you raise your implement, it should raise the implement as well. If you lower it, it should lower the implement. Just my suggestion. So it's looking like two more trips. Two more trips, so it should be good. So that new truck sim game came out. I think it was Monday and Tuesday. It's not Wednesday. And so I don't know. I was kind of looking into it, but I remember playing Euro Truck Sim, and I don't know. It just got boring after maybe a couple hours of playing because the economy. It's not really very sandboxy, I guess, and I like sandbox style kind of games, much like this, where you can pretty much personalize every kind of aspect. But I do like the concept of like building your own like trucking company, but you know, it's really like you can't see your other trucks, you don't see your other trucks driving, you don't really, you know, it's all kind of this. But I think it's kind of a game where you just kind of play it after kind of a long, busy, stressful day. Kind of like this, and you're relying on the scenery. Like, the scenery on that game was probably a lot better than this, and so is the physics. And if you have a nice steering wheel and joystick and shifter and stuff like that, I could see it being really, you know, enjoyable. I'm sure a lot of you guys are playing that now. You know, cheap game, so I was thinking of getting it, but I don't know. Have to watch some more YouTube videos on it and see what I think of it. In that dirt road by 29 and 15. So these garage doors over the sell point, those are all time triggers now. So we're like the dealer and CPS, the gates, I can't control them anymore like I used to. They just operate on their own now, but they open at set times, which is a nice little feature that I just got around to changing the user attributes on the triggers. Doesn't take very long. Saves us from having to open up all the doors and stuff like that. I couldn't get my probe to animate with the trigger though, for some reason. I set it up just like the B-piler tip, but it's not, when I go through it, I can't control it like a door trigger, so I have to investigate that. It's animated, it's got the animation file, but it's just not correctly linked or something with the trigger. Which is really weird because it actually is. It's just another one of those mysteries of this game. You do things correctly and they still don't work. So I think the rest of this grain will be our profit on the great demand, but I think we're about even with base price. The rest of this 300 and whatever thousand liters will all be profit. This is where we'd end up if we didn't have a great demand on our grain. Which, I mean, it's not that bad, but land, but we're renting it, which is pretty expensive still. And then we have like 2.2 million in loans we have to pay off. But we have about 310 more days to fully pay off those loans. So we have quite a few more seasons to go, I think. I don't think it's that much. I actually think it's, we have like 8 more seasons to go until they have to be paid off. I think I have it set up as like a 10-year note, 300-day. Nice thing about this is it's gonna bump up the price of the rest of our crops. Hopefully we get corn and beans coming up soon. This will push the prices of those even higher. One more trip after this and we won't be completely, we'll have completely drained our bins of barley, so. Barley! It's only a 1.7 multiplier, so it's not like one of those epic 1.9s, but it still gets the job done. I'd love to have a 90% increase instead of 70%, but I'm sure we'll get one of those with corn or beans. You know, on crops that are even more dollars per liter, so. Anyways, or a dollar per bushel. I think that's around $6 a bushel, and beans around $10, $11 a bushel, and corn's around $4.55 a bushel, so. Getting a nice multiplier on those drains would help tremendously. so we did about 930,000 liters by ourselves. I'm pretty sure I could have done over a million. Probably could do 1.15 if I needed to with this current setup. Do it easy if I had another. We had 436 first, do that way easy. Oh my god, I forgot again, this guy sucks at corners. Not gonna make the quota doing stuff like that. I'm not sure if we'll be able to get over it. To hop in the truck in the back and haul ass at this last 20,000 or whatever it's going to be. Server lag is not helping the cause. Hopefully I'll be able to get everything. curious what I have left. Yeah, I gotta do some truck again.
My God.